ദൈവത്തിന്റെ വലിയ നാമം വാഴ്ത്തപ്പെടുമാറാകട്ടെ. ഇന്നത്തെ ചിന്തയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി ദാനിയൽ പ്രവചനം 6:28 നമുക്ക് വായിക്കാം.
For today's meditation, let us turn to the book of Daniel, chapter number 6,
verse 28.
Verse number 28.
എന്നാൽ ദാനിയേൽ ദാരിയാവേശിന്റെ വാഴ്ചയിലും പാർസി രാജാവായ കോരേശിന്റെ വാഴ്ചയിലും ശുഭപ്പെട്ടിരുന്നു.
So this Daniel prospered in the reign of Darius and in the reign of Cyrus the Persian.
ദാനിയേലിനെ കുറിച്ച് നിങ്ങൾ ധാരാളം പ്രസംഗങ്ങൾ കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്.
You may have heard many messages concerning Daniel.
എന്നാൽ ഇന്ന് പാലക്കാലം എനിക്കറിയാം ദൈവാത്മാവ് ഈ വചനത്തിൽ കൂടെ പ്രായമുള്ളവരോട് മാത്രമല്ല യുവജനങ്ങളോടും ഇന്ന് പാലക്കാലം സംസാരിക്കുന്നു എന്ന് വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു.
I believe that the Lord is going to speak many of you elders and even youngsters this morning.
ലഭിക്കുന്ന സമയത്തിനനുസരിച്ച് ദാനിയേലിന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിന്റെ 12 ശ്രേഷ്ഠമായ ഗുണവിശേഷങ്ങൾ ഓർപ്പിക്കുവാനാണ് ഞാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നത്.
Within the time allotted to me, I will speak about 12 qualities, specific qualities of Daniel.
നിങ്ങൾ എഴുതുന്നവരെ പോയിന്റ്സുകൾ കുറിച്ച് വെച്ചാൽ ഭാവിയിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് തന്നെ വല്ല യൂട്യൂബിൽ കൂടെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കേൾക്കാം. പ്രിയ ജിജി അത് പിടിക്കുന്നു, വളരെ സന്തോഷം. അനേകർക്ക് ഈ വിഷയം അനുഗ്രഹമായി തിരുവാൻ ദൈവമേ.
And Georgie is recording this, so it will be on YouTube. Many will be able to watch it again. But if you want to take note, please take the notes this morning.
ബൈബിളിൽ വ്യക്തിപരമായി ഏറ്റവും അനുകരിക്കുവാൻ പറ്റിയ ഒരാളാണ് ദാനിയേൽ.
There is one specific individual in the word of God that you can follow. His name is Daniel.
ദാവീദിന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ഹൃദയപ്രകാരമുള്ളവൻ ദൈവത്താൽ സാക്ഷ്യം പ്രാപിച്ചെങ്കിലും തന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ അനുകരിക്കാൻ പറ്റാത്ത തെറ്റുകൾ തന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുണ്ട്.
Even though David was known as the man after God's own heart, a person you can follow, but some of the things you cannot practice in your life.
അബ്രഹാം വിശ്വാസികളുടെ പിതാവാണ്. അധോലോക പർദീസയുടെ പേര് പോലും അബ്രഹാമിന്റെ മടി എന്നായിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ അബ്രഹാമിന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിലും ഉന്നതത്തിൽ പോകുന്ന അനുഭവത്തിൽ തന്നെ താഴ്ചകളും വന്ന സന്ദർഭങ്ങളുണ്ട്.
Abraham is a pilgrim father and he has many good qualities even when the Lord Jesus Christ was speaking about Lazarus, the bosom of Lazarus, he was mentioned, but there are many things you cannot practice.
എന്നാൽ ദാനിയേലിന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ ഒരു കുറ്റവും കാണിക്കാൻ വയ്യാത്ത രീതിയിൽ സ്വർഗം പോലും സാക്ഷീകരിച്ച വളരെ മാതൃകാപുരുഷനായ ഒരു പുരുഷനാണ് ദാനിയേൽ.
And Daniel is a person that he has no fault in his life, even heaven approved his lifestyle.
യെശയ്യാ പ്രവചനം 13:14 വാക്യങ്ങൾ ഇങ്ങനെ വായിക്കുന്നു. ഒരു ദേശം എന്നോട് ദ്രോഹിച്ച് പാപം ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഞാൻ അതിന്റെ നേരെ കൈനീട്ടി അപ്പവണ്ണ കോൽ ഒടിച്ചോ ക്ഷാമം വരുത്തി മനുഷ്യനെയും മൃഗത്തെയും അതിൽ നിന്ന് ഛേദിച്ചിളകയും നോഹ ദാനിയേൽ എന്നീ മൂന്ന് പുരുഷന്മാർ അതിലുണ്ടായിരുന്നാലും അവർ തങ്ങളുടെ നീതിയാൽ സ്വന്തം ജീവനെ മാത്രമേ രക്ഷിക്കുകയുള്ളൂ എന്ന് ഹോമയായ കർത്താവിന്റെ അരുളപ്പാട്.
If a famine and pestilence comes and the nation being destroyed, even though the three men Noah, Daniel and Job were in them, they should deliver, but their own souls be their righteousness with the Lord God.
അപ്പോൾ ഇവരുടെ മൂന്ന് പേരുടെ പേര് ദൈവം പ്രത്യേകം എടുത്തു പറയുമ്പോൾ മറ്റുള്ളവരെക്കാൾ അതിവിശേഷമായ ഗുണമുണ്ടെന്നോ സ്വർഗം പോലും ദാനിയേലിനെ കുറിച്ച് സാക്ഷീകരിക്കുന്നു.
Even though the word of God declared three men of God, Daniel is great among these three men.
ദാനിയേലിന്റെ പ്രവചനം 1:3-4 വാക്യങ്ങൾ വായിക്കുമ്പോൾ ഒന്ന് അവൻ രാജസന്തതിയിൽപ്പെട്ടവനായിരുന്നു.
When you read the first chapter of book of Daniel, you will find that he is from the lineage of kings.
അവൻ യുവാവായിരുന്നു.
He is not only from the royal family, he was a young man.
ശാരീരികമായി യാതൊരു ഊനവുമില്ലാത്തവനായിരുന്നു.
There was nothing wrong with him. He was a very perfect man.
അവൻ വിദ്യാസമ്പന്നനായിരുന്നു.
He was an educated man.
അവൻ വിവേകശാലിയായിരുന്നു.
He was a man of wisdom.
അവൻ കാഴ്ചയിൽ സുന്ദരനായിരുന്നു.
He was so comely to see.
അവൻ വിദ്യാപരിചാരിയായിരുന്നു.
He was full of wisdom and knowledge.
രാജധാനിയിൽ പരിചരിപ്പാൻ അവൻ യോഗ്യനായിരുന്നു.
He was fully qualified to be working in the palace.
അവൻ ഔദ്യോഗികമായി തന്നെ പ്രധാന
He came to the prominent position called
Prime Minister.
In the relationship to the Lord, he became a prophet of God.
ഇത്രയും വലിയ യോഗ്യതകൾ അവന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു.
Great qualities are mentioned in the word.
എന്നാൽ അവനെ ബാബിലോണിൽ നെബുക്കദ്നേസർ രാജാവ് അടിമയായി പിടിച്ചുകൊണ്ടുപോയി.
But King Nebuchadnezzar took him as a slave to Babylon. Not only him, many Jewish boys were brought
to.
And among them, Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. And when they came to Babylonia, the king changed their name. The meaning of the name Daniel means God is my judge. Amen. The king changed Daniel's name to Belshazzar, means the servant of Baal. Hananiah means the one who have found the favor with the Lord. And his name changed to Shadrach. The meaning of Shadrach is the one who was who find pleasure but from sun god. Mishael means he is like unto God. His name changed to Meshach, and the meaning that he is the god, he found favor of goddess of power. Azariah means God is my helper. His name changed to Abednego. He is the servant of the fire. Even though the king changed the name, God did not approve of that name change. God calls him my beloved son Daniel.
നമുക്കറിയാം പണ്ട് കാലത്ത് പേരുകൾ ഇടുമ്പോൾ
we know in ancient time when we give names, and the first spelling, the first letter of father and the first letter of mother will be connected together and we'll give the name. And I praise and thank God for us having the wisdom to name our children the godly name, Joshua, Joel, Danny, and all these names. In time past, a family desired to have a child to be born in their family, but God gave them a girl. And because the Lord gave this child to them, they said it is a treasure from God, and they named the child Nidia. And second time also they were longing for a boy child, the Lord gave them a girl child. And the next one they named Vidya. And third time they decide for another baby boy. And third one also is a baby girl. This is deception from God, so they named Chadia. And they thought fourth one will be a boy, so fourth one was a girl. And they said that's enough, and they call her Maria. And don't just name the child that you are pleased to, but find the will of God and name them. Let us look at the good qualities of Daniel. And the good quality of Daniel is that he is well settled in decision making. Daniel chapter 1 verse number
8. അവൻ കുടിക്കുന്ന വീഞ്ഞു കൊണ്ടും തന്നെത്താൻ അശുദ്ധമാക്കയില്ല എന്ന് ദാനിയേൽ ഹൃദയത്തിൽ നിശ്ചയിച്ചു.
Daniel purposed in his heart that he will not defile himself with the portion from the law, from the king's table.
ദാനിയേൽ വീഞ്ഞു കുടിക്കുന്ന ആളാണ്.
Daniel drank wine. In the word of God it says that Daniel was fasting without taking the wine and bread, that tells you that he used to drink wine. It is not alcoholic wine, it is the grape juice that he drank.
அவர் சக்கில் தாக்கியது யூதின் பட்சணத்தின் ஒரு பாகமாய்.
And part of a Jewish meal is wine.
என்ன பைபிள் புதியதை பத்தி வாசிக்கணும் மீஞ்சி அதுபோலும் குடிச்சு மத்தராகுவார் பாடில்ல.
And the Bible says do not be intoxicated with wine.
என்ன ராஜாவின் போதனம் என்று பரையும்போது தேவன் முன்பாக காட்சி வச்சிட்டு கொண்டு வருகிறாரான இ மீஞ்சி அவருடைய பட்சணம்.
And the portion of the meal come from the king's table is the one first offered to the god and goddesses. And Daniel purposed in his heart that I will not defile my life with that meal. We know that in the prophetic book of Jeremiah chapter 35 it says that the family of Rechab were told to partake the wine and they said we will not partake, something has been forbidden to our life. And they were brought into the temple of God and the vessels filled with wine were presented before them. And they were told that this is given to you because God told us to give this to you.
ഞങ്ങളുടെ പിതാവ് ജീവനോട് കൂടെ ഇരിക്കുമ്പോ ഞങ്ങളോട് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ടോ ബീജ് കുടിക്കരുത്, അതുകൊണ്ട് ഞങ്ങൾ ബീജ് കുടിക്കത്തില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് രേഖാവിന്റെ കുടുംബം ആ തീരുമാനത്തിലുറച്ചു.
The family of the children of Rechab stood for their decision saying that our fathers taught us we should not defile our life with wine, we will not partake that. It was a test given to them by God. Let me tell you, the youth of this church this morning, wherever you go for parties with your friends, if you're offered alcoholic wine or drinks, you should always say we will not partake this because it is forbidden for us. And Apostle Peter says that enough is enough for spending time with the Gentiles. What is the victory in our life? We must have self-control. Proverbs
25:28.
He that hath no rule over his spirit is like a city that is broken down and without walls. We all must have self-control in our life.
James
1:8.
തന്റെ വഴികളിലൊക്കെയും അസ്ഥിരനാകും.
A man with double minded man is unstable in all his ways.
നിങ്ങൾക്കറിയാം യാക്കോബിന്റെ ആദ്യത്തെ പുത്രനാണ് രൂബേൻ.
And Reuben is the firstborn to Jacob.
Reubenne appan anugrahi paraya vilichu.
And Jacob called Reuben to be blessed.
Ingada avarude paranara vaada kondu vellam pole thulumunna pole
nee
srechanagilla.
You will not be prosperous because you are always like troubled water.
വെള്ളത്തിന് രൂപമില്ല.
And there is no shape to water.
ഈ ബോട്ടിൽ ഇരിക്കുമ്പോൾ ബോട്ടിലെ രൂപം.
When the water is poured in the bottle it look like bottle.
ഗ്ലാസ് ഇരിക്കുമ്പോൾ ഗ്ലാസിലെ രൂപം.
A glass of water look like a glass.
എങ്ങോട്ടെങ്കിലും ചരിവ് വന്നാൽ അങ്ങോട്ട് വലിച്ചു പോകും.
If you tilt it it will show the tilted shape.
യാതൊരു നിയന്ത്രണവുമില്ല.
There is no control to the water.
രൂബേനെ കുറിച്ച് എന്താണ് പറയാൻ കാര്യം?
Why Reuben was compared to the water?
അവിടെ വായിക്കുന്നത് രൂബേൻ ഉൽപ്പത്തി 35:22.
Genesis 35:22.
ഇസ്രായേൽ ദേശത്തു പാർത്തിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ രൂബേൻ ചെന്ന് തന്റെ അപ്പന്റെ വെപ്പാട്ടിയായ ഗിൽഗയോടുകൂടെ സഹിച്ചു അപ്പന്റെ വെപ്പാട്ടിയുമായി ബന്ധം പുലർത്തി.
As he had a relation a relationship with the concubine of his father, it was a sin in his life. In order for us to be success in our life, we should not be like water. We should be stable. We should have a firm decision in our life. Therefore, he was not prosperous. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 4 says that you should resist the devil even with your life. Psalms 4 verse 4 says that be tremble and be fearful, sin not.
Hebrews chapter 12 verse 6 parayumbol oru koodila yeshuvagaasam mitchukalendu yeshuvane poraganadu parayum.
In the epistle of Hebrews we read that you should not be like Esau who cast away his birthright for the stew that was brought before him. Those days elder brother had a prominent place in the family. He had a position of a prince, and the lineage of Christ will be through him, and also he has double portion.
இதெல்லாம் அவரு கிட்டானோ
all this will be entitled to him.
அதெல்லாம் ஒரு பாயசம் கண்டப்போ எழுதி கொடுத்து
for one stew he gave up all that birthright.
நீங்க கரியா சுமந்த பாயசம்
it was a red stew.
அதன் ஒரு ஆகர்ஷணம்
it attracted him.
இவர் பரிபல் அவர் பாயசம் உண்டாயிட்டிருக்கியா
and as the Esau was coming home Jacob was making this stew.
நம்ம பாயசத்தை நம்ம மூக்குல ஒட்டடிக்கு பாய் ஏலக்காய் ஒரு மணம் ஒரு பிரத்யேக டேஸ்டா
and when we smelled the beautiful spices in the பாயசம்
now
you will be longing to have a taste of it.
அப்ப இவன் சொல்லு வரையா
and he is so hungry for this too.
இவன் பத்தி பாயசம் வரைக்கும் வரடா
I need this too.
குடிச்சிலங்க நான் இப்ப சத்துவோம்
if I don't partake of this I am going to die.
ஒரு பாயசம் குடிச்சிலே சத்துவோம்
will a person die without taking this too?
ஒரேல அவன் சுடுவேல் மறைஞ்சு ஓடுது இந்த ஜெல்சாவு ஆசை வெனிக்குதா இப்ப தன்னே காது
and Jacob said if you sell me or if you give me your birthright I'll give you this too.
இந்த போலே நோட்டரைஸ் செய்யாது இல்லாத கொண்டு ஒரு பேப்பரை எழுதி கொடுத்து
of just a portion of
nammale aagarshikkina valagaragal unda
there are many things that attract you in this
world yanikkoru kaaryam parayatte
let me tell you one thing
nammale aathmiya valakkunathu endinaana endraan
how do we measure our spirituality
nammale paattu kettalla
it's not through our singing
nammale prasangam kettalla
it's not through our preaching
nammale anya vaatha kettalla
it's not through speaking
nammale aaradhana kettalla
it's not through your worship
nammale aathmaavile aaradhana mathavalla
it's not your spiritual worship
ore aal paavathode kaanikkina murappaana avare aathmiyaraagiradu
the spiritual is measured by your life how much you are resisting temptation or sin in your life
endavachal kaandathin aagarshikkunna oru swabhavam undu
and the magnet has a quality of attraction
enna north pole oda varumba vigarshanam undu
and when it comes to north pole and the north pole of the north side of the magnet it comes it will repel
nee aaradhikkunna nalladana
it is good that you worship
enna paavathoda bandhathulla ninna vigarshanam aanu ninne aanyanaaki maarthadu
the one that make you a spiritual man is depends upon how much you resist temptation and sin in your life.
பாவம் எப்பறாலும் வருதல.
When will sin enter in your life?
பாவம் அவசரம் லெவிச்சட.
As it look for opportunity.
பாவம் அவசரம் அறிக்கொண்டு வரும்.
It will make an opportune time to enter in your life.
ஒரு ரெண்டு எக்ஸாம்பிள் பரையா.
Let me give you a couple examples.
அவ்வாயும் ஆதாமும் கூட ஒன்னிச்சு போயிருந்தாங்கல்
பலத்தினத்திலே. And Eve and Adam were walking together they will not have eaten the fruit.
அவ்வா ஒட்டக்கு
Eve went alone.
அவடா வராஜேபட்டி.
There she failed.
அவசரம் ஒருக்கி கொடுத்து.
And she made an opportunity.
யாக்கோவின் மக்களே தீனா. நேசத்திலே கன்னிமாரே காணவான் ஒட்டக்கு போய்.
And Dana the daughter of Jacob went alone to see the city.
யாக்கோவாரே கூட கொண்டு போயிருந்தாங்கல் அது நடக்கதில்ல.
If she took a couple of her brothers she would not have gotten into trouble.
Let me tell you
girls don't go alone at night time to see the to wander around the cities. And when all the David's soldiers went to the battlefield David stayed back alone in palace.
அங்க ஒட்டக்கு இருந்தது கொண்டான அந்த பாவம் செய்வாரடையா.
Because he stayed alone stayed back alone he committed sin.
അവൻ യുദ്ധത്തിന് പോയിരുന്നെങ്കിൽ അന്നത്തെ നടക്കില്ലായിരുന്നു.
If he was gone to the battlefield, he would not have committed sin. And the opportunity will be brought. Do not look at the wine that is bubbling red in its vessel. And it will come back and bite you. Satan will bring opportunity to partake wrong things. Genesis 39 verse
9.
In this home there is nobody besides me. Because you are his wife, there is nothing is forbidden other than you. This is the statement of Joseph.
Verse 11.
One day he came into the house to do his chores. There was none in the house other than
them.
And the Potiphar's wife made an opportunity to commit sin with Joseph. Satan made an opportunity. There is none in that family other than them. This house is always full of servants. There is nobody else other than them. You may be given opportunity to visit your friends or family alone, but at that time, if you are able to run away like Joseph, you are a spiritual man. Come out among them, you just come out. And just come out among them. Do not touch any unclean things. The victory in Daniel's life is that he was a purposeful man. The second thing that Daniel was victorious is Daniel chapter 2 verse 18. Daniel was a praying man. He was a praying man. The preachers are well known by the world, but a praying man is known by God. Many papers can be written about prayer, but it is difficult to find time for prayer. A man's victory in his life is his prayer life. And prayer is the key to heaven, and it trembles Satan. Many things can be spoken about prayer. Because the lack of time will be
good.
Daniel always prayed. 3 times a day he prayed. Even though there was a decree against prayer, he did not stop from praying. Even though you may not get much opportunity, but at least in the morning and in the evening you must pray. The third thing, Daniel chapter 2 verse 19. And as soon as the secret been revealed, Daniel started praising God. He was a man who praises God. Why many a times you are not finding answer to your prayer? We always bring our need before God instead of praising God. Philippians chapter 4 verse 6. Do not be mindful of a thing. In all be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. Let me give you a couple examples. When we sit down to pray, to find answer to your prayer, you must praise God more than your request. Oh Father, I thank you for giving me your son.
I
thank you for salvation.
I
thank you for my redemption. Lord, I thank you for my righteousness. Lord, I thank you for the spiritual blessings. Lord, I thank you for seating me in heavenly place. Lord, I thank you for making me a blessing. Lord, I thank you for the talents and the grace upon my life. And start examining this. And more than your request, give glory and praise unto the Lord that is deserved to be given. Bible says in everything give thanks. If I start to speak about that, that itself is a message. Lord, I thank you for making me wonderfully and great. Let us look ourselves and praise God. Let me give you an example. Our hair and our eyelash is about 3 finger width. Eyebrows. Yeah, because I have a big forehead, it's about 5 forehead. And the hair grows and our eyebrows doesn't grow that much. It doesn't grow many people. If the eyebrows were growing, you have to move the eyebrow and see people. When I think about my hair and my eyebrows, you praise God. I thank God for God making me wonderfully and fearfully. The 4 things. And he was a man who meditated the word of God. Daniel chapter 9 verse number 2. And Daniel was reading the word of God from the book of Jeremiah and came to the knowledge that the captivity of Israel will be finished in Babylon in 70 years. We must read the word of God in a routine. And the church in Barovia was more better than the church in Thessaloniki. They were always examining the word of God to make sure. Job said, and I keep your word more than my meal. The Lord Jesus Christ said, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that comes from the Lord. David says that in order to meditate the word of God, I am seeking through time and time. Daniel always had a routine of reading a book of God. 5th thing, that he is a man of fasting. Daniel chapter 9 verse 3. When the time came for a need, he sat down with his friends and started to fast and pray. In order for you to receive blessing from God, you must learn to fast. And the Lord Jesus Christ said, this kind of affliction will not go away unless until you fast and pray. It is very necessary to have fasting in our life. The 6th point. Daniel chapter 6 and verse number 3.
An excellent spirit was in him.
Amen. He has a good spirit in him. He has a special spirit in him. And what was told about Joseph? Can we find such a man like a man with the spirit of God like Joseph? Why Moses is a prominent man? And some part of the spirit was taken out from Moses and given it to 70 people. What makes you a special person? The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the one make you unique. Samson said like this.
ശേഷം മനുഷ്യരെ പോലെയാകും.
If my spirit is or if my strength is taken away from me, I'll be like another normal people.
നമ്മൾ എന്തിനാ പെന്തക്കോസ്തി വന്നത്?
Why did you come to Pentecost?
നേരത്തെ നിന്ന സമുദായ സഭകളിൽ എത്ര നല്ലതായിരുന്നു.
It was better in the traditional churches.
കാരണം കുന്ദരിക്കത്തിന് നല്ല മണമുണ്ടോ?
The smell of frankincense.
ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഡ്രസ് കുറവാ. അവർക്ക് നല്ല ഏമ്പോര് നീളക്കുപ്പായം ഇട്ട പുരോഹിതന്മാരുണ്ട്.
And we don't have that long gown, but they have a priest with a long gown.
കാണുവാൻ പറ്റിയ മടുമാകായുണ്ടോ?
And they have a holy place that looks very beautiful.
നല്ല ജനക്കൂട്ടം മടരയുണ്ടോ?
A multitude will come.
എന്നാൽ അതൊക്കെ വിട്ട് പെന്തക്കോസ്തി വന്നാലോ ആത്മാവിന് വേണ്ടിയാ.
You left all that and came to Pentecost to be filled with the spirit.
പെന്തക്കോസ്തിന്റെ ശക്തി എന്താണ്? ആത്മാവിന്റെ ശക്തി.
What is the strength of Pentecost? It's the spirit, power of spirit.
പണ്ടൊരിക്കൽ റഷ്യയിലെ പട്ടി ഇന്ത്യയിൽ.
One long time back, a dog from Russia came to India. And when the Russian dog came to India, found all the Indian dogs are wandering around. And as soon as the Indian dog saw all this special Russian dog, all the Indian dogs came gathered around this Russian dog.
ബോസിനോടെ കട്ടിലേലാ കിടക്കുന്നത് തിരുന്നോ ബിസ്ക്കറ്റും കുടിക്കുന്നോ സൂപ്പ് വാങ്ങുന്നു.
And the Russian dog said that we sleep with our masters and we eat biscuit and drink milk.
പറയ ഇന്ത്യൻ പട്ടി പറഞ്ഞു ഞങ്ങൾ തിന്നുന്നത് എച്ചില ഞങ്ങൾ തിന്നുന്നത് അകത്ത് പോലും കേട്ടതില്ല എന്നൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞു.
And the Indian dog said we only eat the leftover from our master. We are not allowed in the house.
പറഞ്ഞു ഇന്ത്യൻ പട്ടി ഒരു മുസ്ലിം പട്ടി ചോദിച്ചു പിന്നെ ഇങ്ങോട്ട് വന്നെന്ന് ചോദിച്ചു.
And one of the naughty Indian dog asked the question, then why did you come to India? Because Russia is communism, I cannot bark. I am not allowed to bark in Russia. That's why I came here, so I can bark. I came so I can freely bark in India. Why did you come to Pentecost? Good one,
Pastor.
We come here so we can be filled with the spirit and worship the
Lord.
If your worship is not spirit filled worship, what makes you unique? Otherwise your worship is a dead worship. What was the uniqueness in Daniel's life? He had an excellent spirit in him. And that this mighty power is not our own. Let us say it is the gift of God. And this mighty power is poured into the earthen vessels. Let us lift our hand and praise God. Say loud, worship the Lord. It makes us unique that we are worshiping in spirit. The seventh quality, he was a faithful man. Daniel chapter 6 verse 22. Daniel said, O king, I am faithful in before you. I am faithful before God. And many saints are falling away. And many faithful people are coming short. You must be faithful in what is given to you. And one child stole a pencil from school. And the father started beating him. Will you steal pencil again from school? I will never steal. I will bring pen and pencil from the office. As much as you want, I can bring it from the office. This is the kind of father we have. No, we are taking pencil and pen from office and stealing. Wherever you are established, you must be faithful. Daniel was faithful in point number
8.
I want to sit down before pastor make me sit down. He had a helping mentality. Ananiah, Mishael, Azariah were kneeling before before God with Daniel. Daniel was promoted by Daniel's request. King gave this friends other positions in the kingdom.
നമ്മള് സഭയിൽ ജോലി ഇല്ലാത്തവർക്കായി പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചാൽ മാത്രം പോരാ.
We should not just pray for the ones who don't have work in our church. അവർക്ക്
ജോലി കണ്ടുപിടിക്കാൻ നമ്മൾ സഹായിക്കണം.
We must help them to find the search and find jobs
for them. അവർക്ക് വേണ്ടി നമ്മൾ പ്രത്യേകമായി പ്രവർത്തിക്കണം.
We must work to get them into a place.
ഓക്കേ പൈസ വെച്ചോണ്ട് സഹായിക്കാമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ പോരാ.
We must not promise others will help us having money in your pocket. Just like Daniel, we must have the quality of life to help others. He was helping others. The ninth point. He was so much a person who loved his own people. And when he heard the news of bad condition about his people, when he heard and he came to know about the, he fasted and prayed for the redemption of Israel. We must have the love towards our own people. We must never backbite our brothers and sisters. They are God's people. We must only say good things about our people. There is a family in Moab. Mother-in-law and two children. Because the famine in Israel, they came there. They did not say bad things about
Canaan.
They are God's people. God will visit them. Our fathers are Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. She always shared that with her daughter-in-laws. This is why Ruth said, your people are my people. Your God is my God. Wherever you go, I will go. We must be proud of our own people. We must take pride in our own people. He loved his own people. He was a man of courage. What is his courage? During the king Belshazzar's rule, a handwriting came on the wall. His wife said, call Daniel for to interpret that writing. Daniel came and read the writing. I measured on your scale and found the short. And the word that he said, oh mighty king, your father was proudful before God. He was eating grass like an oxen. And you are his son. And you never came to the sense of his father's lifestyle. Who he is talking to? He is talking about this king's father. And he is telling this king that your father was made to eat grass. If I am preaching, I would say your father was eating salad. If he has to come and tell the king that your father, God made him eat grass, look at the courage this man of God has. Ahab came and met with the prophet Elijah. Aren't you the one troubling Israel? Immediately Elijah replied and said, I am not the one, but you and your fathers. And Elijah knew, even though I am facing a king before me, the one who sent me is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. John the Baptist proclaimed, oh children of vipers, if I call you children of vipers, next Sunday you won't be here. They were not afraid of proclaiming the truth of the word of God, but they had the courage to proclaim the truth. 11th point. He always spent time wisely. It's not mentioned here. And after Nebuchadnezzar and Mede and Persians came, Cyrus came into power. Daniel came to see Cyrus. As he was coming before the king, he had the scrolls open from the prophet and he was standing face to face with the king. And he opened the word and gave a message to the king. Book of Isaiah, chapter 44, 27 through chapter 45, verse 4. And it is written like this. Cyrus is my shepherd. And I will open the door for him. I will make all the doors of brass will be opened before him. Before your kingdom was established, your name was written in the word. And Cyrus was so much pleased. Before I was born, my name was written in the Bible. And Daniel said, yes, it is written. And Daniel said, not only your name is written, you will build a temple for God. And Cyrus was so happy. Cyrus wrote a letter. He sent a decree and said, the broken down temple of God should be restored. This is my decree. And all the help was given. We must use time wisely. God will bring some people before you. You must spend time wisely before him. 12th point. He was a humble man. As soon as we say let us pray, he will kneel down. Now who is he? He is a prime minister or a president of 120 states. He can sit in his throne and pray. But he put away all his position and power. Immediately he's told about prayer. He will kneel before God. He will open his arms. There is his victory. Wherever the humility is there, the Lord will lift you up. Wherever you lift yourself up, the Lord will put you down. And I have mentioned that 12 qualities of Daniel. We must have these qualities in our life. And after that, God gave him a send off. Oh, Daniel, you go by the way. After you rest, you will come up at the end to receive your lot. What a great ending. And the most important person that I love is the death of Jacob. He called all his children and blessed them. All the grandchildren he blessed. And he took his staff and he bowed before that staff. I was wondering why he was bowing before the staff. When I studied history, I came to know one thing. All this staff has marks on it. There was no pen and pencil. When God do a miracle, he'll make a line on his staff. From top to bottom, there is lines marking on this staff. Amen. He looked at the staff and saw all the miraculous leading of the Lord, and he started worshiping the Lord from the call from my mother's womb till the end of my life. You led me. He started worshiping the Lord. Then he took his leg and put it on the bed, and he gave up his
prayers.
We must find a good end in our life. We must have a good desire of an end. Let us stand firmly as Daniel did. May the Lord richly bless you through this.
അടികളെ യാത്രയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചാണ് ദൈവം അനുഗ്രഹിക്കട്ടെ.
And thank pastor and the church for giving me this opportunity. Please consider praying for me and my travel. Let us stand before the Lord in the light of the word of God.